Out front tonight, Donald Trump demanding an apology, even though his opponents say he's the one who should say he's sorry. Well, now Hillary Clinton is piling on against Trump. So has he finally gone too far? Plus, the Trump campaign at a crossroads tonight. Another top advisor out. Is the campaign unraveling? And breaking news, protesters on the street in Ferguson, Missouri, a state of emergency there following a night of violent clashes on the streets. Can the police keep the peace tonight, 1 year after Michael Brown was shot and killed? Let's go out front. Thank you, as always. Thanks so much. And a reminder to all of you, Donald Trump, you can hear from him yet again. He will be a guest on New Day tomorrow. That's 7 a.m. Eastern right here on CNN. Out front next, Donald Trump trying to move from the soundbite of the day to serious presidential campaign. Will his policies back up his promises? We take a look. Tonight, the Trump campaign is at a crossroads. Another top advisor. Breaking news, officials declare a state of emergency tonight in Ferguson, Missouri. This follows new violence and new protests 1 year after the death of Michael Brown, an unarmed black teenager shot by a white police officer. Out front for us next, surveillance video captures storm shatters a plane's windshield mid-flight, knocks off the plane's nose, terrifying passengers. Tonight, new audio of the moments after an unarmed black college student was shot dead by a rookie police officer who is white. Listen here. Martin, thank you so much. Out front for us next, tense moments in... Tonight, a federal investigation into how a Delta passenger jet nearly broke apart mid-air. Take a look next, Jeannie Mose on Donald Trump and what all those scowls and smirks, what they're secretly telling us. The many faces of Donald Trump, rarely a happy one. Why is this billionaire so darn grumpy? Here's Jeannie Mose. I mean, you can't top it. I'm just going to pout and sit here and say thank you. Have a good night, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us. AC 360 starts right now. Out front tonight, breaking news, Donald Trump dominating. New CNN poll numbers just released has Trump on top of the Republican pack, this time in the key state of Iowa. But there is one major sign of weakness for the front runner. Plus, more breaking news, a massive explosion, the final death toll still unknown, more than 250 people injured. Wait till you see this amazing video. And allegations of brutal interrogation tactics used on prisoners after two killers escaped from a New York maximum security prison. What really happened there? Let's go out front. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kate Baldwin in for Aaron Burnett. Out front tonight, breaking news, Trump on top. Donald Trump with a commanding lead over his Republican rivals in the key state of Iowa. That's according to a new CNN poll that was just released. Trump topping the field with
uncertainty, and they're looking for a strong leader, and Donald Trump follow them. I think if we were in time of, you know, contentment in the country, you wouldn't see him leading. But, you know, the bigger news to me out of these polls tonight are that, and what do we see on the Democratic side today? A surprise poll out of New Hampshire. Bernie Sanders now leads, maybe small gap over Hillary Clinton. Another anti-establishment.
Time to go. Iowa polls just out. David, Katie, Andy, thank you guys so much. Great to see you all.
Nice, Katie.
Out front for us next, more of our breaking news. A new CNN poll has charged they were beaten and severely abused by guards after that daring New York prison break. But is it true? And Donald Trump, he says he's leaving open the door to a third-party run. But could he win that way, or would he guarantee victory for the Democrats? In breaking news, Donald Trump slamming Hillary Clinton, distancing himself from the Democratic frontrunner despite donating money to her past campaigns. Listen. But it isn't Trump who's being tough on Clinton in the polls right now, for sure. A new poll of Democratic primary. For us next, inmates charged that guards tried to beat information out of them in a desperate attempt to find out more about the escape of two killers from a New York prison. So are they telling the truth? And breaking news, this Tonight, shocking claims of abuse during the desperate hunt for two escaped convicts in upstate New York. Inmates at the Clinton Correctional Facility, they say they were beaten and placed in solitary confinement just hours after Richard Matt and Dave. You heard what Miguel was just laying out. I mean, you have inmates who are now claiming they were not only abused, they were placed in solitary confinement. The New York Times also reported one inmate says that guards put a plastic bag over his head. Do you believe it?
I mean,
did you ever see any retaliation like this yourself?
I've seen many, many forms of retaliation, but I've never seen them put a plastic bag over anybody's head or use anything to choke them out, like a windbreaker. But I did see them choke people out with their arms, their hands.
That this information, these claims are coming from less than reliable sources, is what they're saying.
So a human being is less than a reliable source. So if it would have been coming from somebody on the other side of the wall, it'd be a reliable source. You know, we all make.
Tonight, Donald Trump's Republican opponents not so happy he's standing firm atop the polls. Moments ago, Rand Paul mocking and mimicking the GOP frontrunner. Look. Paul may not want Trump in the Republican primary, but would a Trump third party run be even worse for the GOP? He keeps threatening it. Will he do it? Tom Foreman is out front with tonight's Money and Power. Next, Jeannie Mose with this mid-air collision. And here is Jeannie Mose. AC 360 starts right now. On this Iraq question specifically, but to Rick's point, he's at least laying out policy. And Donald Trump again today saying, it's coming, you wait, it's coming in September. Why is he waiting on rolling out policy, Alex, do you think? Is he afraid of policy?
I don't think he is. It's his Iran position, saying he wouldn't cancel an Obama-Iran deal on day one. That was a point of weakness with the grassroots as well. So, yes, Donald's not giving enough specifics, but they are doing a victory dance tonight, hearing Donald is teaming with him.
The senator from Alabama, of course, he's talking about there. You know what, Alex, Rick, stick around with us. We're going to get a break in. We're going to continue this discussion on the other side. Stand by, guys. A big night for Donald Trump. We've been watching him live. Next, the Iowa State Fair descending. It's a whole lot of fun, but it's also a very big deal. And as many candidates past have found out, one misstep can cost you big. You can only imagine what fun this weekend will bring. We'll be right back. Thank you so much for joining us, everyone. Have a fabulous weekend. AC 360 starts right now. Out front tonight, breaking news, debris found off the coast of Africa. A source tells CNN tonight it is consistent with the Boeing 777, the same type of plane as the missing flight MH370. Plus, barnacles found on the debris could be crucial in determining where the missing plane crashed. But are we any closer now to finding out how the jet with 239 people on board went down? And an exclusive interview with Donald Trump, why he called an attorney who asked for a break to pump breast milk, disgusting. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kate Baldwin, in for Aaron Burnett. I want to welcome our viewers in the United States and around the world. Out front tonight, much more of CNN's exclusive interview with Donald Trump. But first, we have the breaking news in the search for missing flight MH370. Ahead, Donald Trump in an exclusive interview attacking an attorney who asked to take a break so she could pump breast milk.
Donald Trump.
Breaking news, a major development in the search for Malaysia Airlines Flight 370 tonight. Out front next, after an attorney asked for a break so she could pump breast milk, Donald Trump called her disgusting. Tonight, in an exclusive interview, Trump doubling down. And more on the breaking news we're discussing, possible debris from the missing Malaysia Airlines Flight 370. My guest, the husband of one of the passengers on that jet. Welcome back to our viewers in the United States and around the world. Tonight, an exclusive new interview with Donald Trump. The Republican presidential candidate is now in the midst of a new controversy. A lawyer who once deposed him says that he called her disgusting when she requested a break to pump breast milk. Out front tonight, Dana Bash is here with her exclusive interview. And Dana, Trump is not taking that accusation lightly.
No, I mean, that's probably after him so personally. He shoots back, and that's definitely what he did with me today.
Exaggeration? Is it optimism only? I mean, to hear someone who is now a politician acknowledge that he exaggerates, mm-hmm. I can't decide if it's shocking or refreshing.
You know, and that's Iowa, is because he defies convention.
That's right.
And convention, of course, is a his numbers are probably going to go up because the expectations are different for him.
And also, especially talking about defying convention, then you talk about, I mean, flip-flopping is like the worst, one of the worst words in politics ever, but he readily acknowledges it.
He went from advocating model to, which is to the left of most people in the Democratic Party,
exactly,
to being a conservative.
Defying convention, and that's not all of it. Dana's going to stick around with us because there's much more of this. Out front next, more of Donald Trump in an exclusive interview. Now he's invoking a GOP hero. And back to our top story as well. I'll talk to a man whose wife was lost on MH370. Back now with more of Dana Bash's exclusive interview with Donald Trump. Trump, who was once a registered Democrat, he's now running as a Republican candidate for president. He's been accused of flip-flopping on some key conservative issues, including abortion. Dana asked Trump about that today.
Of course, they are and have been for months and months.
I can't tell if he's lowering expectations or he really is not prepping. I think that's just one thing we're not going to be able to know.
Could be one and the same.
I think you're absolutely right. Now, he has gotten into some trouble with his own party, but now I found it fascinating that he told you that now he's getting along with everyone, but that clearly is not stopping him from taking jabs at his GOP rivals and also, of course, Democrats, namely Hillary Clinton, right?
Yeah, I mean, I actually said to him, now he sounds very different. Listen to this. Whether she committed any kind of criminal act.
Exactly,
we should
right.
say that, for the record, eventually became the nominee. The question is whether or not he's right. Does he know something about Joe Biden? I mean,
who knows is for sure. I mean, but the fighting has all been to this point all on the Republican side.
Yes.
So you are seeing,
for the most part,
you are finally seeing with him, he's starting to sharpen his attack against Hillary. You can see where he's turning his attention a little bit.
Absolutely. Everybody on the Republican side who really is a member of the base wants to hear that. So that's not a surprise. But, you know, maybe it is a surprise to
me. Yeah, I think she was in one of the front pews of that wedding, a lot of people like to point out. Again, another bit of the interesting Donald Trump. Dana, you took him on. Thank you so much. Great
Thanks,
to see
Kate.
You.
You too.
Out front for us next, back to our top breaking news story. Debris found that could be missing Malaysia Airlines flight 370. On board, one of them, your wife. Mr. Narendran, thank you so much for your time. Out front for us next, we have a very special out front announcement that you will not want to miss. And a very exciting personal note from the Outfront family tonight. Erin and her husband, Dave, have welcomed a baby girl very soon. Thanks so much for joining us, you guys. AC360 starts right now. Outfront tonight, breaking news. U.S. intelligence shows it's likely that someone in the cockpit of missing flight MH370 deliberately steered the plane off course before it disappeared. Plus, more debris washes up off the coast of Africa. Is it also from 370? Out front tonight, the man leading the search for the missing plane. And Donald Trump, still surging in the polls and now taking time off, headed to Scotland for a golf trip. Let's go out front. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kate Baldwin, in for Erin Burnett. Out front tonight, breaking news. CNN has learned that U.S. intelligence now believes Malaysia Airlines Flight 370's final moments were deliberately caused by someone in the cockpit. In late today, what do you make of this? A U.S. preliminary intelligence assessment, someone in the cockpit deliberately steered this plane off course.
I just hope they didn't spend too long and waste too much time.
And this is carefully worded, David. I mean, it is one step from saying that someone...
I don't know.
Speculate, my friend. Mechanical. You still think mechanical is a possibility?
I think that there's a mechanical option that cannot be ignored. If you look at the examples of pilot suicide, they don't go and fly the plane.
We're going to talk about the debris. The debris that was found thousands of miles from where the main search area was. Were investigators looking in the wrong place the whole time? My guest tonight, the man leading the hunt for MH370. And who exactly are the captain and the co-pilot? What investigators think happened inside the cockpit just before it disappeared from radar? And Donald Trump doubling his lead over Jeb Bush in the latest poll. So why then is the front runner spending the day on a Scottish golf course instead of on the campaign trail? Breaking news on Malaysia Airlines Flight 370. A preliminary U.S. intelligence assessment suggests it's likely that someone inside the cockpit deliberately caused the plane to go off course. We're going to have much more on that breaking news coming up. But right now, there is renewed interest tonight on the men at the controls of MH370. Ahead, our special report on that plane's captain and co-pilot. And the University of Cincinnati police officer charged with shooting and killing an unarmed black motorist tonight. That officer says new video proves he's not guilty. Following a breaking news tonight, CNN learning that a U.S. intelligence assessment shows it is likely that MH370 was deliberately steered off course. The assessment suggests it's likely someone in the cockpit caused the aircraft's movement before the 777 airliner disappeared. It is, of course, renewing focus tonight on the captain and the co-pilot of MH370. Kyung La is out front with more. Donald Trump surging in the polls, leading the pack of Republican presidential contenders, now has a double-digit lead over Jeb Bush. But first, Dana Bash is out front. Dana, thank you so much. Joining me now to discuss, ordained minister Russell Moore. And Dr. Moore, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks for having
me. You heard that part of that interview that Dana had with Donald Trump is getting a lot of attention.
Yeah.
The fact that he says that he would discuss with Republican Party the three exemptions that he supports: rape, incest, and life of the mother in terms of abortion. Is he, with that kind of a stance, is he going to have a problem with evangelicals?
Well, I think there's a bigger problem, which is the fact that he was pro the case when we have right now one of the greatest human rights atrocities and scandals with the Planned Parenthood videos. We need to have a...
See, do you not believe him on his change in stance?
I don't know. Country, how do we work for justice there? And how do we make sure that the human persons are treated with dignity and respect?
With that in mind, Dr. Moore, he was also asked if he's ever asked God for forgiveness. He was asked this at the Family Leadership Summit, and he said, I don't think so. I think if I've done something wrong, I just make it right. He went on then to talk about, I do go to church, I drink the wine, and I take the crackers, but I think that's about it. With that in mind, why then is he leading the pack of Republican candidates when it comes to evangelical Republicans? He's topping, when you see that right there, evangelical Republicans, he's at 20%. What's evangelical seeing him?
As what kind of message can we send? I think time will tell who is going to be chosen to govern.
And it would be interesting. He's going to have to, as Dana said, he will need to expand on those positions in the debate, and I know you'll be watching that
very
closely. Dr. Moore, it's great to see you. Thanks for your
time. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Out front next, there is no crying in baseball. Or is there? Here's Jeannie Moss. AC 360 starts now. Out front tonight, breaking news. Donald Trump on CNN fighting back, refusing to fire a top aide after his explosive comments about rape. This, as a new poll, gives Trump a double-digit lead over Jeb Bush in New Hampshire. Plus, a bombshell confession from prison worker Joyce Mitchell. What did she tell investigators about her relationship with the two escapees and the plot to kill her husband? Mitchell's attorney is out front. And two Florida teens still missing at sea. Their capsized boat was found. My guest tonight, the mother of one of those boys. Let's go out front. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kate Baldwin in for Aaron Burnett, and we are following that breaking news out front tonight. Breaking news, Trump firing back here on CNN. Donald Trump defending his top aide, Michael Cohen, who said this, in quotes, by the very definition, you can't rape your spouse. Michael Cohen, moments ago, Trump dismissed the Daily Beast report and also said he will not be firing Cohen. This all as a new poll of New Hampshire Republicans has Trump now on top with 24%, and that is double Jeb Bush's 12%. Just look at that lineup. And you can be sure, though, that conversation is continuing now ahead of that debate. Sarah, thanks so much. Out front with us tonight, Donald Trump's campaign manager, Corey Lewandowski. Talking about this, allegations from 30 years ago now coming back up. We heard from Donald Trump himself speaking to Don. He says that he disagrees with Michael, but he says that he is not going to be firing him. Why?
Well, look, no one speaks for Mr. Trump.
Of why you want to keep him on board with Mr. Trump, because this is a person, he's not affiliated with the campaign, you say, but he is suggested by the campaign as someone to speak as a surrogate, to speak really on behalf of Mr. Trump. You want someone who says this kind of stuff to a reporter to speak on behalf of him?
Let me be clear, and it's very important to understand the distinction.
Regret putting him out there and suggesting him as a surrogate to speak on behalf?
Well, I can say I've never suggested that.
Has suggested him as a surrogate.
Well, I can say that I get a lot of phone calls and obviously don't have the ability to do all of the requests that we have, but I'm happy.
Yeah, that's no kidding. You want to talk about those poll numbers in New Hampshire, that's for sure. And that had then those poll numbers are following the McCain controversy, and it does clearly show that voters want to hear Trump's message. Tone, though, tone in any organization, Corey, is set from the top. Everyone says that. You guys are really comfortable having someone as part of the organization who says, tread very effing lightly, because what I'm going to do to you is going to be effing disgusting. That's troubling.
Well, let's talk about tone. A lot of candidates have talked about tone. Our country is in such trouble, right? They are literally beheading Christians over in the Middle East. They're drowning these people.
This is like opposition research, people trying to distract? Is that what you're trying to say?
No, what I'm saying is it's not about tone. It's about being able to worry about the tone. Let's worry about putting America back on track and making America great again. That's what we should be focused on.
Are you worried when you have comments like this? Yes, you're focused on polls. I know that you guys are focused on other big issues and you're getting ready for this debate. But you have someone speaking on behalf who's saying, by definition, you can't rape your spouse. Are you worried that this could stick, that this could hurt you with female voters?
Well, look, Mr. Killing Americans.
This does not worry you guys.
Well, I think that what we...
Sometimes amazes me, Corey. I appreciate you coming on.
It's great
Thanks
to be
so much,
here.
Corey. We'll see you soon, I'm sure. Donald Trump, no question, loves to talk about his money. $10 billion, really rich, but is that really true? Bloomberg has been job.
It's a lot to look at.
His financial disclosures and all of that. So you arrived at $2.9 billion. Mm-hmm. As we've heard Trump over and over say, he's worth more than $10 billion. So what's the $7 billion difference?
So we,
for him.
I mean, a $3.3 billion in the value of his brand. How do you calculate the value of a brand, I guess, is where that discussion begins. But Trump has come out today to comment on your story just to Don Lemon in an interview. Listen to what he said. A stupid report, Caleb, and you don't know all the companies that he's dealing with. What do you say?
I appreciate Trump's thoughts. Trump has given us a lot of information to work with.
A lot to work with, and of course he'll have a lot to say about it. So in the end, I think what folks want to know, because he loves talking about it so much, were you able to reach a conclusion? Is Trump exaggerating his wealth?
I'm not going to say he's exaggerating.
No, where the rest of the $7 billion come from. Caleb, good work. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
Of course. Out front next, Jeannie Mose with the biker who... So for the annoying drivers out there who block bike lanes or double park on busy streets, you, my friends, are about to meet your match. Here's Jeannie Mose. I love that people are trying to criticize me. He still lifted up a car, people. That's pretty crazy. I'm going to leave you with that. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll see you again tomorrow night. AC 360 starts right now. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kate Baldwin in for Aaron Burnett. Out front tonight, a major new national poll just out. The headline, Donald Trump is number one. Not only is he leading Republicans in the race for the White House right now, but he has almost twice the support of his closest opponent. The Washington Post ABC News poll was taken just as Trump ignited a new round of criticism, calling out Vietnam veteran and prisoner of war, Senator John McCain, saying McCain was not a war hero. The poll shows Trump's support may have even registered higher, but the pollsters say he did take a hit following his comments about McCain. Meanwhile, no surprise, Donald Trump will not be apologizing to Senator McCain. Instead, Trump remains defiant, doubling down on his criticism of McCain. Here he is just moments ago. We're going to hear from John McCain's son, who is a Navy pilot himself, in just a moment. And you do not want to miss this. McCain's good friend and presidential candidate Lindsey Graham's passionate response to Trump. Strong comments there from Senator Lindsey Graham. Joining me now to respond tonight. So you heard Senator Graham right there. Donald Trump, he says, is a jackass. What do you guys say in response to that?
Well,
coming up with solutions.
Look, Mr. Trump has been very clear. It's not affection. Every time Senator McCain says something, they give him a pat.
You're wrong. These folks weren't crazy. This is another thing to question something that folks say is not in question, is his military service. And that gets me to where we are in the polls right now. This is a big day for your campaign. Donald Trump now topping the latest poll, 24%. It would have been higher had this comment not happened. The pollsters say he took a hit following this. Well, Aaron, they say that
poll?
it did show a statistical significance that doesn't worry you. Bottom line, let's not argue about polls. Does it worry you that they did see a dip in his polls following the comments?
The whole purpose of a long-term poll, I don't guarantee anything in politics, but
front next, convicted killer David Sweat, he reveals that he spent months roaming free inside prison walls till he found an escape route. The amazing new details coming out, that's next. And also our next guest thinks the latest revelations about Bill Cosby could be a game changer. Will he face charges? Just into CNN, stunning new details on how those two convicted killers were able to escape from a New York State prison, triggering one of the biggest manhunts in recent memory. Investigators who have been interviewing the captured convict, David Sweat, they tell the news. Also out front this evening, Arthur, a lot to get through. These details, Harry, are extraordinary. Miguel was laying out some of the new stuff that investigators are getting from David Sweat. The thing that hits me the most is he was working from this past winter through spring. He essentially had free reign from 11:30 p.m. every night to go through the catacombs of this prison till 5:30 in the morning. It's still, doesn't this, shouldn't
it's
that
hard
shock
to
everyone?
It's hard to believe because when he asleep, you know, they work during the day, they have jobs in the prison, work during the day. So, to us, we have to believe if we can't cooperate. And he's just looking to be a bigger hero than he was before when he was in jail.
Our times is that it seems at least one inmate did notice something going on, complaining to them about the noise that they were creating, thinking they heard some kind of assault. And Richard Matt said that, because he's an artist, that he was stretching his canvas. He was working on his canvas, and that's what the noise was about. To me, that just doesn't make sense.
No.
Do you think it was common knowledge that these guys were trying to pull this off, or do you think that the inmates really believed that story?
I don't know. I'm sure. Well, I think the most important thing in this whole investigation is, was there anybody
took advantage of? Clearly, more changes needed there. Thanks, guys. Great to see you. Thanks so much. Out front next, stunning new details about Bill Cosby's once secret life, admitting in a court document to pursuing young women banking on his fame and powerful drugs. Out front tonight, no word from Bill Cosby since nearly 1,000 pages of shocking testimony became public.
Because she is the one person that had the courage to come out in 2005 in a legal...
I mean, come on, people. Serves you right, I guess. Thanks for joining us. AC360 starts right now. Out front tonight, President Obama blasting Republican presidential candidates, calling Donald Trump out by name. Why is he going out of his way to take on the Republicans? Plus, Mike Huckabee not backing down from his controversial charge that the Iran nuke deal would march Israelis to, quote, the doors of the oven. Did he go too far? The Republican Party's chief strategist is out front tonight. And two teens gone fishing, now missing at sea. The massive search at this hour expanding hundreds of miles to the north. Are they still alive? Let's go out front. Good evening. I'm Kate Baldwin in for Aaron Burnett. Out front tonight, lashing out. President Obama diving into the GOP war of words and calling out Donald Trump. In fact, when asked a question about Mike Huckabee, the president seemed to go out of his way to turn his remarks to Trump a number of times. New clues tonight into a Louisiana gunman's final hours before he opened fire at a Lafayette theater, killing two people. Buzz, thanks so much for coming in. You just heard from the pastor there. I mean, it gives you a little window in, to, if you can, into the mind of this killer. The days before the attack, he goes in, he's asking for forgiveness, he's asking for prayer, he's crying, he's depressed, and he's also going on rants, really homophobic rants. What does that tell you? Was that a cry for help?
Well,
points, but then they seek agreement and they seek
for a motive. And the more we learn, the more and more I think that we may never be able to get a firm answer of why. It seems impossible. Buzz, thank you so much for coming in. We appreciate it. Out front next, a massive search area the size, about the size of Indiana, for two teens who went out fishing and never returned. Why searchers, though, say they could still be alive. And a woman's frantic call to 911. And on a much, much lighter note, police are investigating a possible serial killer tonight after a West Virginia woman killed him.
Putting out a statement.
I can't even believe the story. It's amazing how it all came about. And now
she is unbelievably lucky to have made such a smooth, quick move when she did.
Unbelievable. And she was injured in the attack itself. Right. Boris, thanks so much. Amazing. Out front for us next, Jeannie Mose with a very sweet. So his keepers say Rajan the orangutan has always been quite the curious George, and now he's become an online star as well. Here's Jeannie Mose. So cute, kind of, right? I mean, a little bit, yeah, okay. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Be sure to set your DVR to record out front so you can watch us anytime. AC360 starts right now. Out front tonight, it's all about Donald Trump. After dominating last night's debate, he's still topic number one for the other candidates today. And is Trump digging Republicans into a hole with women? Out front tonight, the Apprentice contestant, who is the target of one of Trump's crudest lines. And breaking news, we're standing by right now for the sentencing verdict in the Colorado movie theater massacre. Will James Holmes get the death penalty? Let's go out front. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kate Baldwin in for Aaron Burnett. Out front tonight, Donald Trump dominating. Trump, by many accounts, including his own, of course, the big winner in the first presidential debate. And he's been in a fighting mood all day long, taking on anyone who dared to question him. Trump and his campaign posting and reposting increasingly hostile tweets toward his critics. To the host, network, he said this. Meanwhile, candidates who were trying to talk about anything but Trump today could not escape him. Jeb Bush, in an interview with Fox News, compared him to Barack Obama. Destruction of a presidential campaign over the course of 2 hours. Well, what do you think?
I think we could call that wishful thinking. Republican network, they're not interested in Donald Trump and his supporters. His supporters are the grassroots conservative agents to the Republican Party. This is clearly a gotcha question. Bill Clinton accused serial sexual harasser with accusations still on the table. So also
the man on the stage saying some words and someone and Hillary Clinton's not accused
we have
of that.
Thank you.
And please don't forget, everyone, CNN will host the next Republicans. Out front next, if Trump made one big stumble last night, it may have been with Megyn Kelly and women voters. And Trump once told an Apprentice contestant that, quote, it would be a pretty nice picture to see her on her knees. Well, she is my guest tonight. Plus, Trump brags that he's given money to almost all the other Republican candidates, but has he actually donated more to Democrats? Good TV, at least. And Donald Trump, he's going to be a guest tonight on CNN Tonight with Don Lemon. That is 9 Eastern. After that conversation, you definitely don't want to miss that. Out front for us next, Jeb Bush, with perhaps more at stake last night than any other candidate. Did his debate performance fall flat? And Donald Trump, he bragged about donating to almost all of his Republican rivals. But is that true? Ahead, a special investigation into who gets Trump's money. So Donald Trump used much more than zingers, than just zingers, to take on his Republican rivals last night. Gene Casares is out front. I don't know what to do with my hands now. Thanks for joining us, everybody. AC360 starts right now. Out front tonight, nearly every presidential candidate descending on Iowa for that state's biggest political event of the year. And speaking live in this hour, a rising star in the Republican Party, Carly Fiorina. Plus, Joe Biden consulting political heavyweights about a possible run for president. So could Joe Biden derail the Hillary Clinton Express? And Donald Trump says his favorite book is the Bible. But does he have the right stuff for conservative Christians? Let's go out front. Good evening, everyone. I'm Kate Baldwin in for Aaron Burnett. Out front tonight, nearly every presidential candidate is descending upon Iowa. One of the biggest presidential campaign stops of the summer, now in full swing. The candidates up close and personal with an estimated 1 million Iowans at the annual state fair. The fair, of course, brings together... Tonight, the presidential candidates are making their way to the crucial state of Iowa. Already, former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee, the darling of the event, Trump land his biggest deal yet, winning over the conservative base. Sunland Serfati is out front. Out front with me now, Russell Moore, an ordained minister. So, Russell, Sunland laid it out really well. Donald Trump says he is a religious man, but he is facing criticism, among other things, for that moment when he said, I've got the little cracker, I drink the little wine. Do you believe he's a man of faith?
Well, I don't expect the President of the United States to be a Sunday school teacher, but I find it very hard. And just the entire disposition of the ego, speaking of everything in terms of personal insult against himself, not to mention the fact you have someone who's made his money evangelical Christians are looking for.
I mean, Jeffrey, you hear it. He doesn't believe it. I mean, Russell...
...worry about these issues of social matters or justice issues. Well, Hillary Clinton could say that. Mm-hmm. Just don't worry about abortion. Let's just
argue about the... I don't think that's what he's saying.
...about the economy. In that kind of vulgar, dismissive language, I don't think that's something that's going to go over well with people who follow Christ.
Jeffrey, I want you to wait.
Thanks, Kate.
Of course. Coming up for us next, out front, we're going to... ISIS use chemical weapons on the battlefield in Iraq. We have a live report coming up on this dangerous escalation in the fight against ISIS. Out front for us next, we have a much lighter note. Donald Trump partying at Studio 54. That club's co-founder, Ian Schrager, he talks about Disco Donald and much more. Tonight on CNN, the music of the 70s, Studio 54, was at the center of it all. The disco, the dancing, the drugs, and the celebrities. I sat down with Studio 54 co-founder Ian Schrager to talk about the magic behind the success. Thanks so much for joining us, everyone. We're going to see you again tomorrow night. AC 360 starts right now. President Obama offering a surprisingly candid assessment about the race to succeed him. Why, he says, Hillary Clinton is at a disadvantage against Bernie Sanders as both candidates get ready to face off tonight during the CNN town hall.
He is richer than Donald Trump, way richer. He's actually held office. So if Michael Bloomberg joins the race for president, is there enough room for two billionaires?
And secrets out, folks. The man who quit Ben Carson's campaign is now advising Donald Trump. Barry Bennett is joining us live on whether Trump's ground game in Iowa is good enough to win.
All right, new this morning, a huge non-endorsement, which is actually sort of pretty close
to
an endorsement.
A lot of those these days.
Exactly.
Joining us now to discuss is Karen Finney. Great to see you. Thanks
for
coming in.
Great to see you guys.
So the campaign can be more in prose than in poetry. I mean, does Obama have a point right now? Do you guys need more poetry in your campaign?
You know, I think if you have been watching this campaign, certainly Hillary has been talking about issues. It's an important message for people, and I think people are very passionate about hearing about somebody who really believes not just in the issue.
But voters also want to be inspired, don't they? I mean, the president was talking about poetry versus prose. Mario Cuomo talked about that for generations. And you look at young people, they always want to be inspired. Yeah. They want to dream. And if you look at Iowa right now, people under the 45 getting shellacked. Bernie Sanders at 59%. Hillary Clinton at 27, excited about that fact, because it doesn't seem to be happening.
Well, you know, I have to tell you a couple things. One, the polls have kind of been all over the place.
So
time, I would say, though, our crowds, we've been really pleased with our crowds over the weekend. We're seeing a gorgeous woman president. I think they're excited about her ideas. I think they're really heartened to hear her. This is something I've heard from people many times, that she's actually talking about. Really excited about that as well.
Karen, does your campaign need a glowing endorsement, non-endorsement right now from President Obama? I ask this because this, in recent memory, this is the election of the outsider. Mm-hmm. Could this be a drag on you guys with President Obama speaking too glowingly of Hillary Clinton?
I sure hope not. I mean, I think, you know, the president is very popular and people...
But take that in the context, though, Karen, of just last week when Hillary Clinton was doing an interview with Wolf, she bristled and tried to say that she was
He's been in elected office a longer period of time as part of the pushback for each other. And I think it means a lot to people that here were these two competitors who were so hard fought who are now, that says something about both of their character. So I think that's a good thing.
So another one of the secretary's friends is Michael Bloomberg, the former mayor of New York, who's now apparently considering running, jumping into this race, getting in. What does that say that this guy who's, you know, worked with and seen Hillary Clinton over the years thinks that maybe there needs to be someone else in the race that's not her?
Well, I think he said if she's not
unsatisfied with some of the stances she's taken in regards to Wall Street and whatnot.
Well, look, here's what I would say to that.
Well, would it hurt? How much would it hurt?
It would impact something.
You know, look, I think being on the Republican side, Americans know they have a very dramatic choice between those two. I don't know what choices that I have. Do I want somebody who is bluster and bigotry and let's keep all the Muslims out and we're going
to... Karen Finney, thanks for coming in. Great to see you.
Great to see you guys.
So does Team Bernie, what does Team Bernie have to say about all of this ahead of tonight's big town hall? We need to